Thank you.
Hello, everybody. My name is Nicolas Pardo. I was participating in the panel previously. And what I want to show to you, it's a project that we are trying to develop with several partners from Sweden, Portugal, and Austria that tries to support the cities to make these strategic climate energy action plans. How to define their strategy for the future future decarbonization. The idea of this project came after during several discussions with cities, stakeholders, and industry, that we realized that big cities, they have enough resources to make the energy action plans, but actually at the end, 45% of the total European cities are small and medium. And this represents a considerable amount of people, around 200 million. The question is that these cities, they are signing protocols with the Covenant of Mayors for Climate and Energy, and they have to define these strategies. In up to 2020 was this SEAP, and now we have this SECAP that is more, they have higher challenges. And this was what I mentioned before. We have targets, decision, and implementation for the cities. Targets are very easy to define for them. They want to have this amount of reduction of the CO2 emissions, they want to have this amount of energy generated by renewables, they want to have this amount of energy efficiency and insulation buildings. And for the implementation, it's very easy also for them. They have a lot of companies, stakeholders, environments that they can support to make these actions. But the question is for them is to take decisions. For them, it's very difficult for the small and medium cities to define which are the technologies that they are going to help them really to get the targets. It could be more PV, it could be more related about thermal solar panels, it could be more about biomass. Makes sense to have biomass, it makes more sense to have district heating, space heating, insulation is a good option. If you have insulation, then you have problems with district heating. So this is the goal of this project, to support the cities to make this decision. As I say, they have several constraints. They have constraints in terms of knowledge. Small cities, they don't have like a department, environmental department, or energy department that they have expertise on this. In terms of resources, usually in this type of city, you have maybe one, two, or three people working on this topic in the best of the case. And the local conditions. Cities are very constrained about the local conditions. They know which resources are available, they have forests, they have good solar radiation, and from this, they have to define their strategy that it will affect to them in the next 40 years. So basically, the main goal of the project was to support the integration of the policies and measures, keep the sustainability goals. It's not just to keep CO2 emissions, it's also to take into account air quality, land use, or water use. Improve of the governance, you support to the politicians how to take decisions. They can understand that the decisions that they are taking now, they will affect in the next 20 years. And very important, support the integration of the city actor. That means company, authorities, and citizens. This is very important. What is the opinion of the citizens? Because they are key elements, not just because they are living in the city, because at the end, they are part of the business models that they need to create to make this strategy on board. So actually, this is a little bit technical. This is the value proposition of the project. The idea was to create a platform where you combine scientific models based in Times Markup. This is a little bit specific. It was used because it was developed by the International Energy Agency and actually used by the Commission to develop the targets, energy targets for the member states. And then to link from the environmental aspects, important for the cities in terms of air quality, especially. And of course, to have GIS information. Cities is not like a black box located in some place. It's like it's important to see how is the distribution, which zones are more residential, which zones are more industrial, which zones have more commercial aspects. Because depending about this, the type of zone, you are going different solutions that can be implemented and can be interesting for them. And then, very important, this is in the second block, stakeholders and communication area. It's very important for the cities, for the mayors and for the municipality authorities to explain and to understand to the citizens what they want to do and how this is good for them. For example, usually it was at the beginning when the renewables came into force, it was really a huge problem to put PV panels on the roof, because they thought, the citizens thought that this was not aesthetic. And now, for example, in Germany, it's a nice thing, it's really fancy. So it's important to have this this process to support this communication, to explain to citizens what they have to do it. In this project, it was a strategy to define, because it's like an EU project, European project, to define study cases that make sense for the different regions of Europe. And we took three study cases that I think that are very good. It's Malmö, Almada, and Jutlandsbruk. Malmö is located in Sweden, it's the second biggest city, and they represent like the typical Scandinavian city that is growing a lot. Almada, it's just crossing the river, the Douro, and it's in front of Lisboa. And this represents a typical Mediterranean city where you have huge concentration of population in a small space of land. And then we have this small city of Jutlandsbruk, that is the typical scatter situation that you can find in Central Europe. For example, in Austria, we have Vienna, that is a big city, like 1 million something. But then the second city is Graz, that you have 200,000, and then you have Innsbruck, 100,000, and then you reduce a lot. So basically, in Austria, and actually also in Czech Republic, in Poland, in Hungary, the cities are really small, and they don't have resources to define their strategy. So we thought that this study case was important for Austria. One thing, this is a little bit technical, but the most important thing here is the figure. We have several discussions for the small cities, and they don't have resources to buy expensive platform. They don't have resources to have like a big computer able to make calculations. They don't have resources to make this type of investment. So basically, what we decide, and it was very good approach with our colleagues from Sweden, it's that all the information will be in the cloud. The cities, they are just to connect to the platform, and then they are able to put the data, to run the results of the information, and then to sit there. They don't have to make big investments in expensive software. They don't have to do anything. Just to download a small application like you have in your computer, and then you connect directly to the platform. And then the second thing was, it was a huge discussion, how the cities are able to communicate their strategies. And basically, it's really pretty curious. And depends actually from the size. The really small cities, they are just interesting to use the current social media. They have the website, they have a Facebook, I don't know why, but they have Facebook, they really like it. And then the medium size, like the Almada, they want to make more sophisticated communication, but they don't have resources for this. And then the final thing, the city of Malmö, they have a special communication for the department and they are not interested about to have an additional one. They want to do by this. So we try to find like an intermediate position where the cities, they are able to communicate externally to other websites and try to make something easy for the most interesting ones. Okay, so this is the dashboard of the platform. One of the important things that, and it was the challenges of this project, or it is currently the challenge of this project, it's to make something understandable for the people who is working in the medium and small cities, in the municipalities. As I say, they don't have like usually they don't have technical background, they are not expert in modeling, they are not expert in the environmental issues. Usually it's 1-2 people that they know about the topic, but they don't really know with details about this scientific level. But anyhow, it's this is one challenge, and the other one is how to transform all the scientific sophisticated models to make them understandable to them and to make easy to work with them. Basically, this was a little bit difficult to achieve this, because at the end you have to have a certain amount of data, but what we try to do it, it's to make on this way, to have a very simple issue where the user can put information, can visualize the information, and then they are not aware how difficult are these calculations behind that. Actually, they are really, really complicated. And then for them was very important to make like the workflows to move from one aspect to other one to the other aspect of the platform very easy and very intuitive. In the dashboard, as we see, we have like three main issues. Is the dashboard where the people can go into the project that they want to do it. We have actually three. The projects, a project definition is just to define the model where you characterize your cities. And then the scenarios is you think that how it can be your targets. For example, you can do a scenario target that in 2050, you are going to have 80% of the decarbonization, or you are going to have 60%, or you are going to have certain amount of renewables in the system, or for example, you are going to have certain amount of subsidies. And one thing that is very important also, it's we try in this platform that all the information, because it's in the cloud, all the cities, they can access to the information of the other cities if this is available. That means you can, I suppose, that we thought that some cities, they don't want to show some specific data, but they want to show another thing. So the idea is to create also like a city community where the cities or the workers in the municipality, they can work with each other to understand which are the strategies done by the other cities and maybe to try to think if these strategies are able to stick in their current situation. So basically, you just connect to this. This is actually the only idea. It's to present how looks like the platform and to just to simplify two things. Simplicity in terms of idea or concept, and then a little bit of complexity of the information that you have behind. Basically, you have the basic information of the city is the first thing that the city have to do it. And just they define the current state, they describe the city, and this is not for them because they already know it. It's for the city community to try to explain them which is the current status, where are their targets, where are their objectives and interests and challenges. Other thing that is very important, it's, as I said, city have to be like done by in terms of space. You are able to define different zones when you can characterize its zones according with, for example, industrial sectors, or they are characterized by the residential sectors, or you are characterized more about the residential sector. Also, you can see, for example, in the residential sector, how much, how many houses are single family houses, how much their apartment, the type of technology that you have into. The base data is the characterization of the city. As you know, in this 2020 strategies, the first year, it's to define which is the current status. It's very important to define the technology that you are using, the zones, the sector that you are using, very detailed. And then finally, you define your scenarios development. The scenarios development just basically are drivers. You define some drivers that you want to do it. For example, you want to reduce the cars in a specific zone. For, it's very typical now in Austria that they want to reduce in the city centers the use of diesel cars, or in general cars, actually. Or they want to use the increase of electric vehicles in certain zones. Or they want to, for example, to increase of the PV panels in certain areas, or actually restrict some use of PV panels or thermal solar panels in certain areas. For example, it's forbidden in the historical buildings in Austria. So basically, you can see more or less your targets and objectives, and for this, you generate the different scenarios that you want to develop. But this is one thing, but this is the most important thing for the policymakers and the citizens, to make understandable all the information that you are generating in a way that they can understand. Because we can create complex diagrams, we can create complex way to present the information, but at the end, they cannot understand. So basically, we have some discussions with them, and we identify these four issues that it can be interesting for them. First of all, is the typical bar chart that they can see the impacts in the long term for the different zones. A map to see in which area they are going to have more impact. This one is a slide visualization that can allow us to select easily the scenario that you want to visualize. And this is very important for them to see demand and supply side, how is the energy flows for the different sectors. And you can see, for example, the decreasing of the demand or how this energy can be provided for which fuel and which conditions. So basically, in a summary, what we wanted to develop in this project is a user employment platform for small and medium cities. As I say, big cities, they already have departments and group of people. Integration of the decision of the city actor to try to explain to all of them how to make this strategy and to make understandable for them in an easy way for by visualization. This is something that, please, there are some companies that they are interested in. They just need to click on this and download the tool. And then we want to increase the impact of this tool doing another development related about the circular economy, something that is was posted out as important issue during the panel. So additional information, you have the our website. That's all. Thank you very much.